Is that China is most definitely modernizing its military. And again, you know, the assessment of the nuclear capabilities, this assessment is coming from the Pentagon in its annual report to Congress. And they are saying that that nuclear arsenal allegedly is growing at a much faster pace than previously believed. The Pentagon in this report is now saying that China could have as many or at least 1,000 nuclear warheads by 2030. That's a faster pace than previously reported. Keep in mind, though, you know, the United States has more than 3,700. What missiles you're seeing here is in front of Beijing. Those are the Dongfang 21D, DF-21D. They're not necessarily nuclear capable, but these missiles are known to the Pentagon as the carrier killers. So China is definitely modernizing. And in this report, they also say it cites the construction, the alleged construction of at least three missile silo fields capable of containing hundreds of new ICBMs. And of course, as you mentioned, this report by the Pentagon comes on the heels of those reports that China over the summer conducted hypersonic weapons systems tests. Hypersonic weapons potentially could send missiles and warheads around the South Pole and avoid the Northern Hemisphere anti-missile systems of the United States. And it is something that General Mark Milley told Bloomberg Television last week in an interview that aired last week that was potentially America's Sputnik moment if China was indeed advancing to hypersonic weapon systems.
Steve, we've mentioned that ramped-up rhetoric over Taiwan. There's been a flurry of sometimes worrying conversation happening. Are we seeing Beijing now sort of backtracking that a bit?
Not necessarily backtracking, but probably more clarifying, because again, when you stir the pot, a lot of aromas come up. And I'm not saying China's stirring the pot, both sides, the United States and China, as well as Taiwan, stirring the pot with the rhetoric a little bit. And there's been reports, of course, when state media has come out and Ministry of Commerce, I believe it was encouraging mainlanders to stock up on household necessities and supplies. There were separate reports, unrelated messages claiming to show China as well was preparing to mobilize military reserves. Also, China's state broadcaster said Taiwanese themselves were hoarding their own survival supplies. Well, now state media is coming out because hundreds of millions of posts have been swamping Chinese social media networks, speculating that perhaps some sort of conflict was imminent. State media now urging the public not to overread a Ministry of Commerce statement encouraging families to stockpile. This is simply because of the
December 21st on the calendar. but Chicago prepares months in advance for winter weather.
I say the only thing that surprises the city of Chicago is if it was snow in July.
This fall, the Office of Emergency Management and Communications led a winter weather workshop. Several city leaders collaborated on how to keep people safe during the coldest months ahead.
So the people that were involved last year or the year before may not be involved this year. So it's our job to make sure that they're schooled up, know what some of the expectations are, the capabilities, and resources that are going to be available to get us through this season.
OEMC Executive Director Rich Guidis says they're also coordinating with non-city government agencies to help with winter storms.
Also work closely with our utility companies. ComEd, People's Gas, situation comes up, we have a power outage during a storm. Certainly our vulnerable population is something that we have to pay very close attention to here in the city of Chicago.
Overall, not much has changed for residents from years past. But this year, every plow truck will have GPS software to help drivers navigate their routes. The city is also building a new facility to store road salt and trucks. Streets and Sanitation Commissioner Cole Stallard says despite the labor shortage, they're entering the season with enough drivers to clear the roads.
We have a committed workforce. We onboard 180 drivers for this season to cover, because we still have to pick up garbage, we still have to take down trees, we still have emergencies that we have to deal with, and it's kind of all hands on deck to make sure that the streets are safe and passable.
Reporting in Chicago for AccuWeather, I'm Eddie Victor.
Tongliao City in North China's Inner Mongolia Autonomous Region has been walloped by the strongest snowstorm ever recorded, with five local meteorological stations reporting the maximum daily snowfall in decades, local authorities said Monday. From last Friday to Monday, 28 local weather stations had logged precipitation of more than 30 millimeters, while the maximum snowfall in the city reached 65 centimeters. Most of the city's primary and middle schools and kindergartens have suspended classes. The airport has been shut down, and expressways are subject to temporary traffic control measures. The local government has dispatched snow removal vehicles to work 24 hours a day. Electricity, heating, and water departments have taken measures to ensure the normal life of residents. Community cadres and volunteers are also mobilized to clear snow on the main roads and sidewalks.